China's 200B underground city for 50 million people. Did you know China is moving enough earth to build the Great Wall 30 times over? Except they're digging down, not up. We're talking about excavating 4.5 billion cubic meters of rock and soil. But that's not even the strangest part. This underground megacity will sit 100 meters below the surface, deeper than a 30-story building is tall, with entire neighborhoods that will never see natural sunlight. But here's what engineers don't want you to know. One miscalculation in the ventilation system could trap 50 million people in a concrete tube with air running out in 72 hours. So how exactly are they pulling off the impossible? And what happens if they fail? If you're fascinated by engineering marvels like this, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell. We dive deep into the world's most incredible projects every week. China faces a brutal reality. 1.4 billion people crammed into just 43% of their land. The eastern cities are suffocating. Beijing's got 21,000 people per square kilometer. Shanghai's even worse. And here's the kicker. They're running out of space to expand outward. The air quality, hazardous on most days. The traffic, a nightmare that costs the economy $65 billion annually. Something had to give. Talks of underground expansion date back to the 1960s during the Cold War. Mao Zedong ordered the construction of underground bunkers beneath Beijing, creating a vast network of tunnels designed to shelter millions during nuclear war. They built over 30 square kilometers of underground passages. But these were crude, dark, and barely livable. The technology wasn't there. The vision died with the regime change. Fast forward to 2008. The global financial crisis hit, but China kept building. They'd already mastered high-speed rail, built entire cities in months, constructed the Three Gorges Dam. Their engineers had become the best in the world at one thing, going big. That's when whispers started in the Central Committee about reviving the underground city concept. Not as bunkers, as actual living space. The breakthrough came in 2015. Chinese engineers successfully completed the Xiong'an New Area project, demonstrating they could build smart cities from scratch. They'd also finished the world's largest underground high-speed railway station in Shenzhen, proving they could create massive subterranean structures with natural lighting and proper ventilation. The Communist Party was convinced the technology had finally caught up to the ambition. In 2019, the State Council approved preliminary studies for the Underground Metropolitan Integration Project, or UMEP. The official announcement came in March 2021. Phase 1 construction would begin in 2023 across 7 major cities: Beijing, Shanghai, Shenzhen, Guangzhou, Chengdu, Chongqing, and Wuhan. Completion target? 2045. The goal wasn't just to ease surface congestion, it was to create the world's first truly underground civilization. 22 years to move 50 million people below ground. The countdown had begun. What do you think about this ambitious vision? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. I read every single one, and if you're enjoying this deep dive, give this video a thumbs up to help others discover these incredible projects. The numbers are staggering. We're talking about 3,200 square kilometers of underground space. That's bigger than the entire nation of Luxembourg. The city will stretch across 5 levels, each one 20 meters high. Level 1 sits just 20 meters below ground. This is the commercial district, shopping malls, restaurants, entertainment complexes. It gets natural light through massive light wells that penetrate from the surface. Level 2 is residential, high-rise apartment complexes built downward instead of upward. Each building descends 15 floors underground. Level 3 houses is the industrial sector, data centers, manufacturing, logistics hubs. Level 4 is pure infrastructure, water treatment, waste management, power generation. And level 5? That's classified. Rumors say it's military bunkers and emergency shelters, but officially, it doesn't exist. Here's where it gets wild. The entire city runs on artificial intelligence. The central control system monitors air quality in real time across 47,000 sensors. It adjusts oxygen levels, temperature, and humidity in every sector automatically. The system predicts maintenance issues before they happen. If a ventilation fan shows signs of failure, AI dispatches repair drones immediately. It's like the city has a nervous system. Transportation is revolutionary. Forget cars. They're banned underground except for emergency vehicles. Instead, there's a network of autonomous pods running on magnetic rails. You step into a pod, speak your destination, and you're there in minutes. The system can move 12 million people per hour. There are also bicycle highways, yes, underground bicycle lanes that stretch for hundreds of kilometers, all climate controlled at 22 degrees Celsius. Lighting is the real genius. Engineers developed artificial sunlight panels that mimic the sun's spectrum perfectly. These panels cover the ceilings and adjust throughout the day. Morning light is cooler and and bluer. Evening light is warmer and redder. Your body's circadian rhythm stays normal. People living underground won't even realize they're missing the sun. At least, that's the theory. The vertical farms are next level. Level 3 contains 800 square kilometers of agricultural space. LED lights optimized for plant growth. Hydroponic systems that use 95% less water than surface farming. They'll produce enough food to feed 30 million people. Rice, vegetables, even fish farms, all underground. China's solving food security and space constraints in one shot. Every neighborhood gets a sky park. These are massive atriums that rise up through all 5 levels. Trees, grass, artificial clouds. Some are 300 meters wide and 100 meters tall. They pump in fresh air from the surface and create the illusion of being outdoors. There will be 240 of these across the 7 cities. The project includes the world's first underground international airport, built at level 4. It can handle 50 million passengers annually. Planes land on the surface, then descend via massive elevators to underground terminals. Passengers never need to go back up. They can catch a magnetic pod directly to their underground hotel. And sustainability? The entire system runs on nuclear fusion reactors with backup from geothermal energy. They're drilling down to tap into Earth's heat. Zero carbon emissions. The waste management system is fully circular. Organic waste becomes fertilizer for the vertical farms. Plastic and metal get recycled on site. Nothing leaves the underground system. It's a closed-loop ecosystem. China claims this will be the world's first carbon-negative city. Not just carbon-neutral, they say they'll actually remove CO2 from the atmosphere. The vertical farms and forest atriums will absorb more carbon than the city produces. If it works, this becomes the blueprint for cities worldwide. The scale of this project is mind-blowing, but wait until you hear about the massive investment behind it. Before we dive into those numbers, which feature impressed you the most? Let me know in the comments. Let's talk money. The official budget is 200 billion, but here's the reality. It's going to cost way more. Phase 1 alone, covering just Beijing and Shanghai, has a price tag of $85 billion. That breaks down to $45 billion for excavation and structural work, $22 billion for transportation systems, $12 billion for environmental controls, and $6 billion for AI and smart systems. Where's the money coming from? The central government is fronting $120 billion through special infrastructure bonds. State-owned enterprises like China Railway Construction Corporation and China State Construction Engineering are contributing $50 billion in exchange for long-term operating rights. The remaining $30 billion, foreign investment. Singapore's sovereign wealth fund put in $8 billion. Middle Eastern investors, another $12 billion. Even some European pension funds are betting on this. Here's the comparison that makes your head spin. 200 billion is more than the GDP of Hungary. It's triple what China spent on the Three Gorges Dam. It's equivalent to building 50 international airports or 15,000 kilometers of high-speed rail. This is the most expensive construction project in human history, period. But China's playing the long game. They project the underground cities will generate $2.3 trillion economic value by 2060. That's an 11-to-1 return on investment. The logic? By freeing up surface land for parks and development, property values will skyrocket. Underground commercial rent will be 40% cheaper than surface retail, attracting businesses. And housing 50 million people, underground means Beijing and Shanghai can finally breathe. The economic multiplier effect could be massive. There's also a hidden military value. An underground population center is basically immune to aerial attack. That's worth something in an age of hypersonic missiles and drones. The Pentagon knows this. So does the Chinese Communist Party. Construction kicked off in August 2023 in Beijing's Tongzhou district. Right now, they've excavated 2.4 million cubic meters of earth. That's just 0.05% of the total. But the real achievement is the technology they're testing. They're using the world's largest tunnel boring machines. These things are 18 meters in diameter, the size of a 5-story building. They can dig 30 meters per day while simultaneously installing reinforced concrete walls. It's excavation and construction happening at the same time. Shanghai started work in January 2024. They're focusing on the Pudong underground zone. Progress is faster there because the soil composition is more favorable. They've already completed 15 kilometers of primary tunnels. The goal for 2025 is to have 200 kilometers of tunnel network operational across both cities. By 2028, they want the first residential units ready for occupancy. That's when people actually start moving underground. The contractors involved read like a who's who of global construction. China Railway Group is leading the Beijing excavation. China Communications Construction Company handles Shanghai. But they've also brought in international expertise. Germany's Herrenknecht AG provided the tunnel boring machines. Japanese firms are advising on earthquake resistance. Remember, this has to survive a magnitude 8 quake. South Korean engineers are consulting on the artificial lighting systems. Testing is already underway. They've built a full-scale prototype neighborhood in Zhuhai, 50,000 square meters of underground space with 500 volunteer residents living there for 6 months. The data they're collecting on air quality, psychological impact, and system performance is feeding directly into the main project. Early results? Air quality is actually better underground than in Beijing's surface air. Residents report feeling safer and less stressed. But there are issues. Some people experienced vitamin D deficiency despite the artificial sunlight. They're adjusting the light spectrum to fix that. The project is currently 3% complete in terms of excavation, but 28% complete in terms of planning and design. Every system has been digitally modeled. They've run thousands of simulations for emergency scenarios, fires, floods, power outages, earthquakes. The entire city has been built virtually before a single person moves in. That level of preparation is unprecedented. Key milestone coming up, June 2026. That's when the first complete vertical section, all five levels, will be finished in Beijing. It'll house 100,000 people as a test case. If it works, they accelerate. If it fails, they pause and redesign. The whole project hinges on that moment. Let's be real. This project has problems, big ones. First up, geology. Digging this deep, you hit water tables. Beijing sits on top of an ancient lake bed. Groundwater seepage is a nightmare. They're installing drainage systems and waterproof barriers. But one major leak could flood entire sectors. Shanghai has it worse. The whole city is sinking at a rate of 2.5 centimeters per year. Adding massive underground weight could accelerate that. Engineers say they've accounted for it. Critics aren't convinced. Ventilation is the killer issue. Literally, you're putting 50 million people 100 meters underground. They need fresh air constantly. The system requires 4,200 ventilation shafts pumping air down and cycling CO2 out. If even 10% of those fail simultaneously, oxygen levels drop dangerously fast. There's redundancy built in, but redundancy fails too. One engineering professor at Tsinghua University called it a failure cascade waiting to happen. The government wasn't happy about that quote. Then there's the psychological factor. Humans aren't meant to live underground. Studies show that prolonged absence of natural sunlight causes depression, anxiety, and cognitive decline. Sure, they've got artificial sun and sky parks, but is it enough? The Zhuhai prototype showed promising results, but 6 months isn't a lifetime. What happens after 5 years underground? 10 years? 20? We don't know. Nobody's tested this at scale. Financial transparency is another landmine. China's infrastructure projects have a history of cost overruns. The Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge was supposed to cost $10 billion, final price tag, $20 billion. There's no reason to believe this project will stay on budget. Some economists predict the real cost will hit $350 billion. Where does that extra $150 billion come from? Taxpayers. And with China's economy slowing down, debt levels rising, that's a tough sell. Environmental groups are furious, moving 4.5 billion cubic meters of earth. Where does it go? The official plan is to use it for land reclamation along the coast and for building artificial islands. But that disrupts marine ecosystems. The construction noise and vibration are already affecting underground aquifers. Some wells in Beijing have run dry. The government blames drought. Activists blame the digging. Then there's the social issue. To build this, you need to displace people. Hundreds of thousands of surface residents are being relocated. Compensation is offered, but it's not always fair. There have been protests. Videos leaked online showing police forcibly removing elderly residents from their homes. The government scrubs them from the internet, but the damage is done. International human rights groups are watching. And here's the elephant in the room. What if it fails catastrophically? A structural collapse, a gas explosion, a disease outbreak in enclosed spaces. Any of these could kill thousands in minutes. There's no easy evacuation from 100 meters down. The emergency plans call for evacuating 50 million people through 8,000 exits. That's 6,250 people per exit. In a panic, that's a stampede. It's a risk you can't engineer away completely. But here's the flip side. If this works, it changes everything. Start with economics. The project is creating 12 million jobs, construction workers, engineers, AI specialists, urban planners. That's absorbing unemployment and training a workforce in cutting-edge technology. By 2045, China will have an entire generation of workers who specialize in underground construction. They'll export that expertise worldwide. Real estate is the gold mine. Surface land in Beijing currently costs $15,000 per square meter in prime areas. Once 50 million people move underground, surface population density drops by 60%. Land values could double. Parks, green spaces, cultural centers. Beijing could transform into a livable livable city again. Shanghai too. The economic value of that transformation is in the trillions. Transportation benefits are immediate. Beijing's traffic costs the economy $8 billion annually in lost productivity. Underground, there's no traffic. Commute times drop from 90 minutes to 20 minutes. That's an hour and 10 minutes per person per day returned to productive use. Multiply that by 50 million people, that's economic efficiency on a scale we've never seen. Then there's the environmental win if they deliver on the carbon negative promise. Vertical farms produce food with 95% less water and 80% less land than traditional farming. If this model works, you can feed billions without destroying more forests. The climate impact could be revolutionary. China becomes the hero of the environmental movement. That's soft power they desperately want. National security is quietly a huge benefit. An underground population is protected from airstrikes, nuclear fallout, and biological weapons. In an era of rising tensions with the West, that matters. China's leadership sleeps better, knowing their urban population isn't a sitting duck. It's a strategic advantage no other nation has. Innovation's spillover is real. The technology being developed here, AI city management, closed-loop ecosystems, advanced tunnel boring, artificial sunlight, all of it has applications elsewhere. China's already talking about licensing this technology to India, Indonesia, and African nations facing similar urbanization crises. This becomes a tech export industry worth hundreds of billions. And there's a social equity angle. Underground housing will be 40% cheaper than surface housing. That means middle-class and working-class families can actually afford to live in Beijing and Shanghai again. Right now, those cities are playgrounds for the ultra-rich. This project democratizes access to China's economic centers. That's politically powerful. Global prestige is the cherry on top. China wants to be seen as the leader of the 21st century. Building the world's first underground megacity. That's a statement. It's the Great Wall, the Terracotta Army, the Three Gorges Dam, all rolled into one. It puts China on the map as the civilization that achieved what no one else dared to attempt. That's legacy building for Xi Jinping and the Communist Party. So where does this go? Phase 1 wraps in 2035. Beijing and Shanghai fully operational with 15 million people underground. Phase 2 starts immediately after, expanding to Shenzhen, Guangzhou, and Chengdu. That adds another 20 million by 2042. Phase 3 brings in Chongqing and Wuhan, completing the 50 million target by 2045. After that, there's talk of Phase 4 expanding to secondary cities, Tianjin, Xi'an, Hangzhou. The ultimate vision is 200 million people living underground by 2070. But it's not just China. Other nations are watching. Singapore's already in discussions to build a smaller underground district. Tokyo's exploring options for earthquake-proof underground neighborhoods. Even Dubai's interested. Underground cities in the desert make sense when surface temperatures hit 50 degrees Celsius. This could be the template for 22nd century urban living. The wild card is climate change. If sea levels rise faster than predicted, coastal cities worldwide will have no choice. Going underground might not be ambitious. It might be necessary. China's betting they'll be ready to sell the solution when everyone else is panicking. There's also the space connection. Learning to build self-sustaining underground cities on Earth, that's practice for Mars colonies. Elon Musk is watching this project closely. The life support systems, the closed-loop ecosystems, the psychological management, it's all directly applicable to extraterrestrial colonization. China's not just building for Earth, they're building for the solar system. Will it work? Honestly, nobody knows. The engineering is sound on paper. The ambition is there. The money's flowing. But this is uncharted territory. We're going to find out in real time whether humans can live underground long term, whether AI can manage a city this complex, whether the economics actually work. The next two decades will answer those questions. One thing's certain, this is the most audacious infrastructure project in human history. It's either going to be the triumph of engineering that defines the 21st century, or it's going to be a cautionary tale about hubris and overreach. Either way, we're all going to be watching. What's your take on this mega project? Do you think it's worth the investment? Or are the risks too high? Would you live underground if it meant cheaper housing and a better environment? Share your thoughts below. I love hearing different perspectives. And don't forget to check out our video on China's artificial sun project right here. Another insane attempt to solve impossible problems with engineering. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.